Oh, hi. I reckon one of the best versions of Mr. Blue Sky around is the Pomplamoose version. It is a lot of just infectious fun to watch and listen to, and really easy and encouraging to play along with the uke. If you're alone at home, it's nice to be able to play with a band, and Pomplamoose kind of create that open environment for you to do that. I'm using an 8-string tenor ukulele today. It's standard ukulele tuning. The only thing that this 8-string has is echo strings on the 4th and the 3rd strings. The rest of the tuning is just the same as a standard uke. Pomplamoose play this in an A flat. So the easiest way to do this that I've found is just grab a capo, put it onto the 3rd fret, and that enables you to use some pretty familiar basic ukulele chords, and you should be able to play along with this relatively easily after some time. So to begin, the very first chord is an F, and an F is the second string on 1st fret and the 4th string on 3rd fret, and it just sounds like this. The other thing about this song that is really helpful too is you can use a very basic strum. So it actually begins with just a downward strum, and as the song progresses you might mix that up with your own versions of up and down. It's really good to interpret it with what really suits you and your own ears, I think, rather than give you a whole breakdown of the rhythms that I use. But that's where it starts, with a basic down strum. The other thing it does in the very first verse is midway through, you then put just close off the 1st string on 3rd fret. So it goes from that basic F to this. So it should sound like this. Sun is shining in the sky, there ain't a... And then it goes to an E minor seventh. Now an E minor seventh is the 1st string 1st fret and the 3rd string on 1st fret. Sounds like that. A cloud. And then it goes to an A. An A is the 3rd string on 1st fret. And then it goes to a D minor. And a D minor is the 2nd string on 1st fret. And then the 3rd and the 4th strings on 2nd fret. Then it goes to a G. A G is the 1st string on 2nd fret, and also the 3rd string on 2nd fret, and the 2nd string on 3rd fret. And then it goes to an E minor. An E minor, you can keep that 1st string on 2nd fret, and then 2nd string on 3rd fret, and then 3rd string on the 4th fret. And it goes back to the A. And then to a B flat. You can simply close off the 1st and 2nd strings on 1st fret, and then the 3rd string in 2nd fret, and the 4th string on 3rd fret. And then it moves to a C. C is just the 1st string on 3rd fret. And then back to an F. F again is the 2nd string on 1st fret and the 4th string on 2nd fret. And then back to the C, which is that 1st string on 3rd fret. So I'm going to play through that slowly, and you'll be able to find the chords in the notes below as well. So it should sound a little like this, but this is a very slow version. So that again is the F, and with the 1st string on 3rd fret. So it's on the F, then to the E minor 7th, to the A and to the D minor, and then to the G, to the E minor, and to the A, and to the B flat, and to the C, to the A, and then the C. And that just plays through again. What I'm going to do is just have a little bit of Pomplamoose in the background, and I hope that's not going to infringe anybody's rights of fair use for instruction. I'll just have that playing and I'll play along with it just to give you a feel for the chords and the strumming. And of course, you can just take your time to build up your ability to play the chords and to do the transitions. But I hope you'll see it's an achievable goal and just a really fun rendition to be able to play along with. So we'll do that first and then we'll come back and have a look at the chorus. So that's just a rough playing through with the first and second verses. I hope that made sense to you. I hope you sort of picked up that the strumming can be as simple as just that downstroke, and as you get more proficient, you can mix that up and just practice those chord transitions over and over. For the chorus, there are some very familiar chords in this that we used in the verse, but there's also two different ones. I'm just going to go through the two different chords now that weren't used in the verses. The first one is a G minor. A G minor is the first string first fret, and the third string second fret, and the second string third fret. So again, for that G minor, it's the first string first fret and the third string second fret and the second string in the third fret. And the other chord that's different is an E flat. So the E flat is first string in first fret and then second and third strings on third fret. Should sound like that. First string, first fret, second, third strings on third fret. That's the E flat. So that G minor and the E flat are the only two extra chords in the chorus that we haven't played in the verse. So I'm just going to play slowly through and talk through the chords for the chorus. The other thing about the chorus too is it's a simple downstroke. Starts on the D minor. The D minor again is the second string, first fret, and the third and fourth strings in second fret. Mr. Blue, then it goes to the F. Sky, please tell us, B flat, why you had to, and then to the F. Hide away, and then to the G minor. That G minor again, first string, first fret, and third string, second fret, and second string, third fret. For so long, and back to the F, so long, where did E flat? And you can just pluck those strings, fourth, third, second, fourth, or any combination that works for you, you can fit it in. That's that E flat. That E flat again is the first string, first fret, and the second and third strings, third fret. And then back to the B flat. And then to the D minor, Mr. Blue, F, sky, please tell us, B flat, why you had to, back to the F, hide away, to the G minor, so long, and then to the F, so long, where did, back to the E flat, where did we go wrong, and then close out the chorus on the B, and go back to the faster repeated downstrokes. Ready for the first little solo piece. In that solo, it's the same chords as the verse. The only thing that happens is in the very last section of it. There's a B flat, and you stay on that a little longer, then the F, and then the C. There's a dropped C chord that you would have used in the verse, but that goes in the solo. So we'll go through that again, and I'll call out the chords as we go through the chorus and also that solo section. So get ready with the D minor for the chorus as it rolls in. D minor, F, B flat, F, G minor, F, E flat, B flat, D minor, F, B flat, F, G minor, F, E flat, B flat. Get ready for to go to the F, F, E minor seventh, A, B minor, G, E minor, A, and stay on that B, and go to the F. And a C. So I'm just going to play through most of the song from the introduction through the first two verses, through the chorus, into the solo, into the next verse and part of the next chorus before the repeat start. And then I'll stop. You'll have enough by that stage with all the chords you need and a basic feel for the song, hopefully to be able to navigate your way kind of through the rest of the sections. The only thing I've left off is the final movement of the song, which is really, really fun. I tend to think of it as like a Fleetwood Mac homage almost. If I work on that at some stage, I might include it. But at the moment, I think it's enough to work on the chords and the transitions and all the movement and the fun of being able to play along with Pomplamoose for the classic ELO song, Mr. Blue Sky. So I'll put this on and I'll call it the chords as we go. Have fun with it. E minor 7th, A, D minor, G, E minor, A, B flat, C, F, C, F. E minor 7th, A, D minor, G, E minor, A, B flat, C, F, C. And into the chorus, D minor, F, B flat, F, G minor, F, E flat, B flat, D minor, F, B flat, F, G minor, F, E flat, B flat. Into the solo, we go to an F. And then to the E minor seventh, A, D minor, G, E minor, A, B flat, F, and C. Back to the verse, F. E minor seventh, A, D minor, G, E minor, A, and B flat, C, F, and C. To the chorus, D minor, F, B flat, F. G minor, F, E flat, B flat, D minor, F, B flat, F, G minor, F, E flat, B flat. And then it just repeats its way through and kind of loops around. Have a lot of fun with it. We'll catch you later.